Shalom, shalom. Kahalayim la, Yahweh Vashem Yahusha, Bahashim Rakakodash. Up honor to the apostles and to the editors of Great Millstone. Much peace, love, and salutation to all the brothers from his work and truth to sincerity. Shalom, this is the brother Patah back again through the Spirit with another lesson. Lord willing, be edifying. This is the book of Psalms, chapter 118, and I'm going to start at verse 4. It says, let them now that fear Yahweh say that his mercy endures forever. And so that's what we count on. We're able to do this ministry because of the mercies of the Lord. And that's why we always, you know, pray to the Lord to give us mercy, give us, you know what I'm saying, strength to endure, because we're not perfect. You know what I'm saying? The scripture says our righteousness is as filthy rags. Let's get that real quick. We're trying to keep the law, statutes, and commandments to the best of our abilities. But the scripture says, all have sinned and fall short of the glory. Isaiah 64 and 6. But we are all as an unclean thing. And so we are unclean because of the flesh that we reside in is subject to sin and death. You know what I'm saying? We can't be perfect in these bodies that we reside in, that our spirits are trapped in. It says, and our righteousness is as filthy rags. And we do all fade as a leaf, and our iniquities like the wind have taken us away. See, all have sinned. So Romans 3 and 23, it says, for all have sinned and come short of the glory of the Lord. So we ought not to worry about the things that we can't change. And we can't change the fact that we reside in this sinful flesh. We just got to have faith in the Heavenly Father, Yahweh Shemel Shah. And in hopes of being delivered and, you know, saved from these corruption bodies of corruption, you know. There's another scripture I was gonna get. Our righteousness is as filthy rags. This is Isaiah 4 and 4. It says, when Yahweh shall have washed away the filth of the daughters of Zion, and shall have purged the blood of Jerusalem from the midst thereof by the spirit of judgment and the spirit of burning, Yahweh will create upon every dwelling place of Zion and upon her assemblies a cloud and a smoke by day, and the shining of a flaming fire by night, for upon all the glory shall be a defense. So the Lord is going to wash away the filth of our people. He's going to do that, but the spirit of judgment and the spirit of fire, the spirit of burning, because a lot of women are going to be judged in these last days, and they're going to be purged. They're going to be purged through that nuclear fire, and that's going to make them right. You know, they're going to have to perish on this side because they don't want to follow after the Lord. But after that judgment, they're going to be reborn. You know what I'm saying? They're going to come back through the loins of the elect in the kingdom, and they're going to be righteous. But they gotta suffer that judgment on this side. But the scripture says, all Israel shall be saved, you know. And the Lord is going to be with us forevermore. We're never going to be separated from Yahweh Shemel Shah again. You know, he's going to dwell with us. The Lord is going to dwell with us, man, forevermore. You know, it's the book of Isaiah chapter 6, start at verse 5. It says, you know what, I'm going to start at verse 4. It says, and the post of his doors moved at the voice of him that cried, and the house was filled with smoke. Then said I, woe is me. No, I'm going to start at 3. Isaiah 6 and 3, it says, and one cried unto another and said, holy, holy, holy is Yahweh of hosts. The whole earth is full of his glory. And the post of the doors moved at the voice of him that cried, and the house was filled with smoke. Then said I, woe is me, for I am undone, because I am a man of unclean lips, and I dwell in the midst of people of unclean lips, for mine eyes have seen the King, Yahweh of hosts. So when he seen, you know, we seen this vision, he felt unworthy because he was unclean, you know. And that's how we all feel at times, man. You know, sometimes you feel like you're not worthy because we're so filthy, man. We're so, our body, we dwell in this wicked flesh. You know what I'm saying? We don't want to, you know, sometimes you be like, damn, bro. You know, but we can't dwell upon that, man. You know, just like when Peter met Yahweh Shah, he said, get thee away from me because I am an unclean man. You know, he didn't feel worthy of Yahweh Shah's presence because we're so filthy, man. But the Lord is going to clean us off. The Lord is going to dust us off and make us right, man, so we can be in his presence, in his tabernacle forevermore. Because the Lord is holy. He's clean, man. We can't, you know, the Lord, you can behold iniquity, man. You know? He's so righteous, man. He's so perfect. And we're just so filthy, man. Isaiah 6:6, it says, then flew one of the seraphims unto me, having a live coal in his hand, which he had taken with the tongues from off the altar. And he had laid it upon my mouth and said, lo, this hath touched thy lips, and thine iniquity is taken away, and thy sin purged. So that's what we hoping for. We hoping for the Lord to purge our sins, man. To make us clean, to make us right, to quicken us. You know what I'm saying? That word quicken means to make alive. Because right now we're dead because of sin. Our bodies are dead because of sin. As Psalms 118 and 5, it says, I called unto Yahweh in distress. Yahweh answered me and set me in a large place. This is the point, verse 6. Yahweh is on my side. I will not fear. What can man do unto me? So that's what the mentality that we got to have. We got to have that unbeatable, that undeniable, what's the word I'm looking for? Indomitable. Let me look up that word again. You got to have that indomitable mindset. Indomitable. Yep. Indomitable. We got to have that indomitable mindset that we cannot be tamed or subdued, because that's exactly what Esau wants. He wants to tame, he wants to subdue us. You know, he wants to be his dumb dogs, man, doing his will. But we're doing the will of Yahweh Shemiah Bashah. We serve a greater, we serve a great power, man. We got to be hard to tame, man. Esau can't tame us, man. Because why? Because of Yahweh Bashmiel Shah, because we believe in the Lord. So the word indomitable, he says that cannot be tamed or subdued. Because that's exactly what he wants to do to this work. He wants to subdue it. He wants to conquer it. But you will never, in your not even a million years, Esau, in your whole eternity, you will never subdue the men that the elect of Yahweh Bashmiel Shah. And that's a fact, man. It says untamable. From Latin, Dimitri, to tame, reference to persons or personal qualities, unyielding, persistent, resolute. So impossible to subdue. So it's impossible to subdue the elect, and it's impossible to subdue the men. The word of the Lord, because that's what Esau is attempting to do. He wants to subdue the word of Yahweh Bashmiel Shah, but he will never be able to do it. Psalms 118:7, it says, Yahweh taketh my part with them that help. Yahweh Selakia, Psalms 118:7, Yahweh taketh my part with them that help me. Therefore shall I see my desire upon them that hate me. It is better to trust in Yahweh than to put confidence in man. It is better to trust in Yahweh than to put confidence in princes. All nations compass me about, but in the name of Yahweh will I destroy them. Because Yahweh is our power source. Yahweh Bahashim Yahusha is our unlimited power source. And he causes things to go our way. When we please the Lord, when we're doing the works of the Lord, when we believe in him and having faith in him and praying towards his name, these are things that are building our relationship with the Lord. And he's going to cause things to go your way. If it benefits the ministry, man. Or any other thing. if it's according to the will of the Lord. And the Lord ain't gonna allow this devil to come down upon us to. The Lord ain't gonna allow this devil to subdue certain men, man. We may have to suffer, but the scriptures tell us the Lord is not gonna leave us defenseless. Psalms 119:25, it says, my soul cleaveth unto the dust, quicken thou me according to thy word. Like I said earlier, like that word quicken means to make alive. Let me see if it's on the only etymology dictionary. Okay, the word quicken, it means quicken, come to life, receive life, give life to, return to life from the dead. And that's exactly what we did. We was in a dead state, and the Lord presented his word unto us, and that word made us alive. It brought us to life. It gave us life, man. You know? So that's that. So let's get Psalms 119:37 says, turn away mine eyes from beholding vanity, and quicken thou me in thy way. I'm just reading a couple of these precepts about being quickened. Quicken, Psalms 119:40. Behold, I have longed after thy precepts. Quicken me in thy righteousness. Psalms 119:50. This is my comfort in my affliction, for thy word hath quickened me. So we're going to have comfort in affliction. Why? Because of the word. It made us alive. What does the scripture say? Wisdom and knowledge shall be the stability of thy times. Let's go to that word, stability. It says firmness of resolve, mental equilibrium. Firmness, solidity, stability, durability. State of being difficult to overthrow. Power of remaining upright. Ooh, remaining upright. What did that remind you of? The word integrity. Ooh, steadfast, firm. From the Latin stabilitium, a standing fast firmness. What the scripture says about that? Steadfast, unmovable, always abounding, unmovable. Nope, I'm spelling that so wrong. Let me just type in steadfast because it's not popping up. Steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord. Where is that scripture at? There it is. 1 Corinthians 15:58. It says, therefore, my beloved brethren, be ye steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord, for as much as ye know that your labor is not in vain in the Lord. So it says the word stability means steadfast, standing fast, firmness, figuratively, security, steadfastness. Steadfast, firm in the physical sense, state of being difficult to overthrow. And that's exactly what we got to be. We got to be difficult to overthrow. We can't reason with this devil, man. We got to be like a rock, man. We got to be like a stone that this devil cannot push, can't move, man. Got to be like a great millstone. It says power of remaining upright. That right there reminds me of the word integrity, which means uprightness. It says meaning continuance in the same state. So we got to continue in the same state that we're in, which is what? Yahweh Bashem Yahushah. It's the word stable means trustworthy, reliable, constant, steadfast, virtuous, unchanging. So that's what we got to be, stability. This is the quality or attribute of being firm and steadfast, a stable order, especially of society, the quality of being enduring and free from change or variation. That's a heavy word right here, man. Ultimately, it goes into faith also, being stable. So wisdom and knowledge shall be the stability. Let's get it. Isaiah 33:6, and wisdom and knowledge shall be the stability of thy times, the firmness of thy times. the steadfastness of thy times. So this word, this wisdom and knowledge of the scripture, is going to keep us steadfast. It's going to keep us unchanging, unmovable, man. It's going to keep us firm. It's going to keep us upright. Let's go to the word integrity. So that's why it behooves you, man. Look up these words, man. The word integrity, blame, innocence, blamelessness. Where is that? I know uprightness is in here somewhere. The wholeness, perfect condition. I know I seen complete soundness, completeness, wholeness, purity, correction. I thought uprightness was in here. Integrity, an undivided or unbroken completeness, or totally with nothing wanting. Oh, what does that remind you of? That word integrity. Let's go to it real quick. Psalms 34. Psalms 34 and start at verse 9. It says, Psalms 34 and 9. It says, oh, fear Yahweh, ye his saints, for there is no want to them that fear him. Well, doesn't the scripture say that about the word integrity? It says undivided or unbroken completeness or quality with nothing wanting. So those that believe in the Lord. Oh, here it is. The word links integrity. If I'm saying that right, it's lucky if I'm saying it wrong. It says a whole number. Intact, whole, complete, figuratively untainted, upright, literally untouched. So integrity is from the word, oh, this is the root word of integrity. Okay, so beautiful. I was looking for the word upright, because I know it's in here somewhere. Oh, here it is. I looked over it and it says the sense of wholeness, perfect condition is attested from mid 15th century that of soundness or moral principle and character, entire uprightness or fidelity, especially in regard to the truth and fair dealing. Exactly. Regarding to the truth, we want to remain upright and fair dealing, man, because this world is not upright and fair dealing. This world follows after the vibration of Satan. So, Psalms 34 and 9. Oh, fear Yahweh, ye his saints, for there is no want to them that fear him. So, if you fear the Lord, you ain't gonna want for nothing, man. You ain't gonna want for nothing. Verse 10. The young lions do lack and suffer hunger, but they that seek Yahweh shall not want any good thing. Why? Because the Lord is gonna provide all the good things that you need, man. Come, ye. Okay, that's it. Begging bread. I got one more precept. Lord willing, this lesson, man, feel good about this lesson. Psalms 34, 37, and 23. The steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord, and he delighteth in his way. Though he fall, he shall not be utterly cast down, for Yahweh upholdeth him with his hand. Because these people, this world don't understand, we may seem to fall, be in a bad position, but guess what? The Lord put us there. And guess what? The Lord will deliver us out of there if it's his will, man. These people don't understand the power that they're dealing with. But we, that have the eyes to see, that have the understanding and the hearts to understand, we see it, man. But this world, they ain't on the same vibration as us, man. They're on a low level because they don't have the light, man. They're stuck in darkness. So they can't see the glorious light. Verse 25, it says, I have seen the young and now... I have been young and now I'm old, yet have I not seen the righteous forsaken, neither his seed begging bread. Another scripture that backs that up real quick. The book of Psalms, Sirach chapter 2, verse 10. It says, look at the generations of old and see, did ever any trust in the Lord and was confounded? Or did ever abide in his fear and was forsaken? Or whom did he ever despise that called upon him? Those are all rhetorical questions, man. Nobody. None. Zero. Squat. Whatever you want to call it. But the number is zero. Because the Lord is not going to forsake the men that believe in him. He never did, man. He may have put them through hard trials and they had to go through hardships, but guess what? They end up coming out of it, man. And he made a way for them to escape. Real quick, let's go to it. The book of First Corinthians 10 and 13. It says, there had no temptation taking you, but as some such as coming to man. So all the things that we go through are coming to man. No more everyday, you know, joke afflictions. But guess what? The difference is we have the Heavenly Father, Yahweh Bashmi Al Shah. But God is faithful, who will not suffer you to be tempted above that ye are able. So every brother have this certain measure. You know what I'm saying? Every brother has their certain measure of faith. And that's how they're going to be tried, according to their measure of faith. It says, but with the temptation also make a way to escape, that ye may be able to bear it. So the Lord is always going to make a way for you to come up out of that situation, to prevail out of that situation, man. He's always going to make a way, especially for his elect, man. So we have nothing to worry about, man. We just got to believe in these scriptures and take it to our grave, man. Strive for the truth unto death, and the Lord will fight for you, man. And that's what we got to do until the end. If we end up losing our life, then so be it, man. We got a kingdom coming. We got to look at the bright side of things, man. We got everlasting life. Esau ain't going to never be able to do anything to us again, man. Because we're going to have the rod in our hands, and we the ones going to be smiting these devils. So with that, man, Lord willing, let's was uplifting and edifying through the spirit and power of Yahweh Hashem Yahusha. I'm going to close out by saying, Ka halayim la, Yahweh, Bahashem Yahusha, Bahashem Rakakodash. Double honors to the apostles and to the elders of Great Millstone who rule and teach well. Much peace, love, and salutation to the brothers doing this work in truth and in sincerity, man. I feel good about this lesson. Lord, lead, brothers, edifying. Shalom.